everybody, welcome back to Live on Stage. I am your host, Lucio Fernandez. Muy buenas noches a todos. Bienvenidos a En Vivo y en Escena conmigo, Lucio Fernandez. Le tenemos esta noche preparado un show fenomenal, lo mejor que ha venido aquí a Live on Stage, En Vivo y en Escena. Soy bilingüe, caballero, así que hablo de todo, hasta Spanglish. Porque aquí tenemos esta noche un tenor fabuloso, creo que es tenor, no sé, habla bien varonil, pero se llama Mariano Vidal, con ustedes aquí mismo, Mariano Vidal, aquí en este escenario, aquí. Y también tenemos con nosotros a Milly Quesada, la reina de merengue aquí, qué cosa más grande, yo no sé qué voy a hacer con este show. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we have a great show in store for you guys, because we have an incredible tenor, an opera singer, I don't know what he sings, boleros, opera, I don't know, Japanese songs, but he's right here. Mariano Vidal, right here on this show, ladies and gentlemen, this is incredible. I'm so excited. I'm beside myself. Don't tell me what to do. Excuse me. I am doing my show. When you become a producer, like they have on David Letterman, which they can look up information online, then you can talk to me, okay? Please. I'm tired of this. I'm not going to take this much longer. It's not easy for me being on here live on stage. I got all kinds of crazy people hanging out right here. I have Jay behind the camera with William. They're giving me direction. How can I work? How can I work? Ladies and gentlemen, don't call me. I don't want a studio audience. Don't call me and tell me you want a studio. I'm not going to have a studio audience, okay? I want my peace and quiet. I have a hard time enough dealing with Jay and Anna and William and the crazy producer over there. Let me just do my show. Anyway, we have with us, what's his name again? Producer, what's the name? Mariano Vidal, right here on this show. Mariano Vidal and the queen of merengue, Milly Quesada. It sounds like a cheese. Quesadilla. Quesada. Quesadilla. No, Milly Quesada. She's Dominican. She sings merengue. You know, merengue, cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. It's like a cha-cha-cha going 1,000 miles a minute. Anyway, we have the show here. It's a great show. Ladies and gentlemen, stop talking to me. I'm going. Let's go see the show. Mariano Vidal, right here on Live on Stage. And you come back to me, and we'll talk a little bit more. Peace out. Hey, everybody, welcome back to Live on Stage. We're here with me, with Lucio, and we have a guest here. He's a singer, he's an actor, he's a dancer. I don't know what he does, but he's here on Live on Stage. So let's see what makes him tick, what makes him boogie. His name is Mariano Vidal. Mariano Vidal, aprendan en español, caballero. Estamos aquí en nuestro estudio con el cantante, el tenor increíble, el lírico, Mariano Vidal. Yo no sé si este hombre canta, si baila, si va a las calles, y no sé por qué tiene pelo blanco. Mariano Vidal, díganos, ¿de dónde salió usted? Si es japonés, si es ruso, si es cubano, si es de las Islas Canarias.
No, nacido en Cuba. I was born in, many years ago, several decades ago. That's why I have the white hair. And I came to from Cuba to the United States in 1961 in the Peter Pan program. I was one of 14,000 boys and girls that left Cuba without their parents.
That's incredible. Tell us, for the people that don't know what the Peter Pan experience was like, how did you come? Did you come by yourself? Did you come with your family? What was that experience like, and how did it form you as an artist?
It didn't form me as an artist at all, because that was a period of time where I stopped singing. I started singing at a very early age. I was about 5 years old, but to answer your question, it was very difficult and trying times, because my brother and I came here without our parents. So it was extremely difficult.
Did your parents ever make it to the U.S.?
Yes, thank God for that. They came about a year later.
Now, Mariano, you tell us about your singing career. We know you're an artist. I know you're a singer. I'm just joking around with the audience, because they call me up, and when I don't do that, so I have to do it for them, you know. My friend at Castaneda, Havana, New York, doesn't like when I do that. So I'm trying to reach a middle ground. Anyway, forget about me. It's not about me today. It's about you. Tell us about your art. Tell us why you start singing. How did it happen? And you get family support, a little bit of that.
Now, nobody in my family sang, or nobody in my family were musicians, aside from the women in the family. And in old Cuba, all the ladies played the piano. And I was inclined at a very early age to play the piano, but my parents wouldn't hear of it, because that was not a thing for the man to do. And, to make the long story short, I was allowed to sing, and I started singing in the boys' choir at a very early age. And I remember that my brother, who was a star a singer, child soprano, if you will, kept telling the priest, you got to listen to my brother. You have to listen to my brother. So one day when I was 5 or 6, my mother brought me hand in hand to the chapel where they were having rehearsals. And the father, who was the choir master, heard me sing. And he said, or so I'm told, ¿Quién te mandó aquí, Papá Dios? So in other words, he said, who sent you here? God the Father. So that was probably a lot lower. That's probably not true, but that's what I heard my entire life. And I sang in the choir until we came to the United States. And then, of course, with all the trials and tribulations of being in exile and being a refugee and not having enough of anything, I just applied myself academically until I had an opportunity to go back and sing, and I did. And it was pretty much thanks to my wife who got me in touch with a couple, Vittorio Molillo and Tony D'Andrea, that were formidable voice teachers in Fort Lee, New Jersey, many, many years ago. And my wife and I have been married for a long, long time. I studied with them for several years. And I remember that I first, about the only thing that I, and I'm sorry if I'm talking too much, you're not asking me any questions. The first thing that he asked me to sing was, he said, well, sing something that you know. And back in those days, about the only thing that I knew was Granada, right? The Agustin Lara, the Mexican song. Granada, tierra. And I remember the teacher saying, no, none of that Spanish trash. You're going to learn opera. So I said, okay. So for many years, it was opera, Neapolitan songs, opera. And it was only after many, many years that I kind of rediscovered Cuban songs and zarzuela, which is our, our Spanish operetta, if you will. And that also in Cuba, we had a lot of zarzuela, and many other countries, South America, the Philippines, zarzuela, one of them is Maria Lao, and the Spanish zarzuelas, La Gran Vía, all those beautiful what modes of music. And that's what I started picking up years later.
So you basically started singing since you were in Cuba. You came to this country, and that's when you found that you really had a knack for it, or a love for singing and performance. And based on your experiences in school, they said, "Hey, this is what you should be singing. You should be singing opera." About when did you find that you discover Hispanic music or Latin music aside from zarzuelas?
Well, the first time that I entered a vocal competition, I won first prize, and it was for a Spanish voice. And right then and there, I met this incredible pianist who was actually accompanying a competitor. And I saw this guy and I heard that music. And I said, my God, who wrote that stuff? And somebody said, Ernesto Lecuona. I said, Ernesto Lecuona, the great Cuban composer. So I said, I didn't know he wrote songs for people to sing, classical, lyrical songs. I thought it was all instrumental. So after that, I applied myself and I coached with Gilberto Perez Labastida, that we all know in these environs, for several years. And that's how I rediscovered the Cuban sound and the Spanish sound.
Now, do you still do the opera, or do you do more zarzuelas, or do you do like the contemporary Latin stuff or Cuban stuff or the Latin standards?
I do pretty much everything. I don't like to be on stage anymore because I don't like to work that hard, and I could never get my stage left and then my stage right, and then there's an owner, your other left. And stuff like that. So I don't want to be on stage doing operas anymore. What I do now is I do a lot of concerts. And I have, as a matter of fact, in a couple of weeks, we have a beautiful concert coming up with the Delaware Valley Opera. It's called Voices of the Valley, and it's a tri-series. In other words, it's a series of different concerts. The first one is Spanish. So in that concert, I'm thrilled, because I'm going to be doing a Targo Argentino, El Día Que Me Quieras, I'm going to do Alma Llanera, Venezolana, Juram in Mexico, I'm going to be singing Cuban songs, I'm going to be singing the song from the Dominican Republic, Preciosa, o Preciosa, de Rafael Hernández de Puerto Rico, and a couple of zarzuelas. Also, joining me on stage will be a wonderful soprano, Emily Storrs, and the great Metropolitan Opera tenor, Nico Castell.
Wow, pretty impressive. Now, so from what I gather, you sing in English, you sing in Spanish. Do you have a language that you prefer to sing in? And following that question, do you sing in other languages, being that Italian and German are the operatic languages?
I never did sing a German opera, and probably that's the best thing that I could do, because German is a very difficult language, at least for me. I have managed to sing a German song here and there, like Dein ist mein ganzes Herz and Vienna, City of My Dreams. I don't know if you know those beautiful melodies. But I try to stay away from German. Sung in French. I like the language that preferred language is the language or the tongue that I'm singing at the moment. If it's a Neapolitan song, it's just an incredibly beautiful language, dialect. It's just so rich and voluptuous that when you sing, I don't know, what is it, you know, like Oso Le Mio, you know, to the first one that comes to mind, it is so rich and an incredible substance and tremendous feeling. But somebody once said to me, he says, oh my God, you're Spanish. So I like singing in Spanish, obviously. It is a beautiful tongue, a beautiful language, and I enjoy it. I enjoy singing in English, Spanish and English.
Now tell us, some of the people that you've performed with, or some of the people that have accompanied you, some of your friends, tell you a little anecdote, you know, throw here and there, throw some names around. I throw them all the way around just to make myself feel important.
Oh my God, I don't know. One of the incredible nights that I ever remember was Meme Solis, and if you know Meme Solis.
I was hoping you mentioned Lucio Fernandez, but okay, we'll take Meme Solis.
Well, no, but you know what I'm talking about, right? I'm talking about who else? Who was that incredible Cuban? Alfredo Munar. These are incredibly just big Cuban names from decades past.
When you say incredible Cuban, I hope you said Lucio Fernandez, but what, go ahead.
I'm going back decades, of course. You know, you're a young guy.
25.
25, right? I'm pushing 30 myself. And the anecdotes. I sang for Celia Cruz. I Bebo Valdez at the piano, and I forget what she says. Bebo, de donde viene? Where does I forget the rhythm invention that he created? And I said, where did that come from? And he looked at me like, what is this guy nuts? It come from La Clave. So he sat down to play. I forget what I asked him. I forget. And so here it is, Bebo Valdez at the piano, and I'm singing to, so I have a lot of tremendous, wonderful memories.
And you're a tenor, obviously, I think.
No, I'm a bass. No, I'm a tenor, and one of my best friends is like my brother, Paquito Rivera, you know, he doesn't play the piano, at least I've never seen him play. You know, he sits down and he sat on my piano, he kind of tickles the ivories a little bit. But and Brenda Feliciano, the great soprano, Pablo Singer, Pablo Singer, great conductor, and I did a Maria Loa, not that I was Maria Loa, I was El Niño Fernando many years ago with Brenda Feliciano singing the role of Maria Loa and Pablo Singer at the Batana Town Hall. I've sang at NJ Pack with Paquito and Brenda at Wild Recital Hall of Carnegie Hall, where we did Paquito's composition of a parody de Cecilia Valdez called Cecilio Valdez, El Rey de La Habana. It's a contemporary operetta, and I'm honored that Paquito asked me to, so I kind of inaugurated, along with Brenda, a couple of excerpts from that operetta. It's more like an opera, because there's not too much dialogue. And we hope that one day, sooner rather than later, this opera is going to hit the world, and it'll be taken to Europe and many other places. So we're looking forward to that.
Zarzuela is almost like a lost art, isn't it?
Zarzuela is, unfortunately, it is. I did in New York City, believe it or not, in New York City, I did El Dúo de la Africana, and I did La Tabernera del Puerto. No puede ser, esa mujer es buena. You know, right? So every once in a while, somebody has the energy and the guts to kind of bring it back. Pablo Singer did it with Maria Lao. So I hope we're going through a cycle. I know that about 20, 25 years ago, Plácido Domingo brought it from Spain to Madison, of all places, Madison Square Garden a couple of times. That was very thrilling. I remember seeing Victoria Los Angeles, may God rest her soul, at the Town Hall, where she also, Victoria Los Angeles, one of the greatest sopranos ever. And she was big into Zarzuela also.
You know, I got stuck when you say Carnegie Hall, and I'm thinking, from Carnegie Hall to live on stage. That sounds real good to me. Anyway, we have a lot of Mariano left, and in fact, let's just cut right to a clip, because this is incredible. Hearing you sing is quite a pleasure. Mariano, thank you for being here. Thank you for giving us the interview. I hope you come back again, but right now we're going to check you out singing. A last message to the audience?
No, to the audience, that I'm so lucky for the day that our paths crossed. And you have asked me on occasion to sing for you in Union City, and just wonderful, memorable experiences, and meeting Megan and Jay and William and Anna. It's just terrific. So I thank you for that.
Thank you. But of course, what he really means, he was a pleasure to meet me. You know, Anna and Jay, they're okay. And Willie, man, he's all right. And Megan, that tough director, producer that I have. But I can't go there because they'll cut my camera right off. So I got to deal with this. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let's go check out Mariano. Vamos a chequear como canta Mariano y canta de todos los idiomas. Es una cosa fenomenal. Check this out and then we'll go back to me in the studio, all right?
Linda flor de alborada, que brotaste del suelo, como la luz del cielo, tu capullo que escapa de las rosas de encanto, el pensil te ama tanto. Loco de amor, siente celos de la fe, del aire y del sol.
Talking about zazuelas. What is a zazuelas? I don't know what he's talking about. Napolitan thing. I was thinking I was gonna get a pizza. Nothing. What is he talking about? I don't know what he's talking about. I thought he was just a singer. I thought he sang, you know, Will.i.am songs or something. He's talking about, I couldn't even pronounce it. What the heck is he talking about? ¿Qué está hablando ese hombre? ¿Viste cómo tiene pelo blanco? Más pelo blanco que yo. Es una cosa increíble. Yo espero que yo en dos años más no tenga tanto pelo blanco. Imagínate, me va a dejar mi esposa. Yo le llevo a mi esposa 30 años. Si me deja con ese pelo blanco, me deja. No, that's not true. I'm sorry, honey. She's also the producer. This is why I'm getting fired. And she's cutting me right now. Cutting me. Anyway, can you believe this? This guy, what an experience. What a singer. Did you hear him sing? It was phenomenal. I wish I could sing like that. I can't even sing a note. Even if someone sang for me, I couldn't even lip sync that well. It's incredible. Qué cosa más grande, tremendo cantante aquí en vivo y escena. Qué placer tenerlo. Cuando Papo ve esto, que tengo un cantante, ¿verdad? Aquí se va a poner. No, Papo's my... He's my friend. I'm just joking around. Papo knows that I'm joking around. Come on. You know, people, this is incredible. The talent that's coming here, the people that are calling us, is incredible. Even Obama was calling me. I know I'm lying. I'm just playing around. Can you please just let me do my show? Listen, do you pay me? Do you pay me to do the show? You don't pay me, right? So I can say whatever I want, because if you don't pay me, the day you pay me to do this show, then I'll do whatever you tell me to do. Now mind your business. Okay, Jay, just focus on me, baby. Focus on me. Let William concentrate on the camera. Just focus on me. Direct the camera towards me. The audience wants to see me. Okay, they want to see Mariano. Mariano told his friends to watch him here. So Mariano's Cuban, so everybody in Cuba is trying to log on. They can't log on. They can't log on because they can't put two tin cans together to communicate through the internet. That's all they have in Cuba. Castro even took away the tin cans. They have nothing. All they have to do is paper, put paper together like this and put a little string and try to communicate. That's how they communicate in Cuba, because he took everything away. There's nothing left in Cuba, not even horses. They ate the horses. There's nothing. That's what Castro does, people. Anyway, enough talking. I know. We're talking about music. I know that. Anyway, this is a music show. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't that phenomenal? Anyway, next up we have Milly Quesada coming your way. We have a Cuban and a Dominican, opera and merengue together. What a mix. Anyway, check out this interview with Milly Quesada. We'll listen to her music and then come back to me here in the studio. Peace out, everybody. Come back. All right, come back. Milly, bienvenida a Union City. ¿Cómo te sientes aquí con tu público que te ama, te quiere tanto aquí en Union City?
Hello, Union City. Estoy muy feliz de estar aquí, de verdad que sí.
Bueno, Union City te quiere mucho. ¿Quieres mandar un mensaje muy caluroso a ellos?
Claro que sí. No importa si hay sol, si no hay sol. Fíjense que Union City dice presente en todos sus eventos. Es una ciudad muy solidaria, muy linda. De hecho, el hecho que estamos celebrando esta inauguración del Union City High School es un testimonio más de cuán unidos son los latinos. Y en esta oportunidad, aquí en Union City, estamos celebrando en grande nuestra latinoamericanidad.
Qué linda. Y ahora nos vamos con el show de Milly Quesada aquí en Union City. Se va. Ya. That is the first merengue artist we have on live on stage. And that's because I coaxed her. I paid the manager a couple of extra bucks to get that interview. Milly Quesada right here on live on stage. With us right here, Quesada. No, Quesada, no, all the Dominicans are going to get pissed off at me right now. Se van a encabronar los Dominicanos conmigo. Esa es Milly Quesada, la reina del merengue aquí en Union City. La tuvimos, no en el estudio, porque tuve la cogí en la calle. Estaba ahí vendiendo unas gomitas en la esquina. Entonces la cogí y la puse en el programa de televisión. Milly Quesada aquí. Jay Peña, no me llames, eso fue jugando nada más. Yo sé que tú la trajiste aquí con Johnny Ventura. Eso fue un juego, Jay, no te pongas ahí, que tú eres un panda mío. Así que, ¿qué más? What do you want to talk about? We have Mariano Vidal, incredible singer. We have Milly Quesada. You got to check out this show every single week because this is hot, baby. Where else are you going to find a Cuban tenor with a merengue singer? It's the best. Ed Castaneda, don't call me complaining about this show. You told me I can do whatever you want as long as I change the credits at the beginning of the end. Ed Castaneda from HavanaNewYork.com, supporting the musicians. We love that guy. We got to check his website out. He's incredible. And the director's cutting me. Please, let me talk about Ed. Ed is a supporter. He supports the show. He supports the artists. We got to talk about HavanaNewYork.com. The New York Times is writing about them. This is incredible, ladies and gentlemen. It's phenomenal. This is why Jay lost his hair, because this show is hot, 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 hot. Jay Gonzalez, you remember we had him a couple weeks ago? I never heard from him again. What a character. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you dug the show. Doug, is that a word, Doug? Doug, is that a word, or is this just a name? Doug, you know, like dig, but dug, digged. You can't say digged. You gotta say dug. Like, right? Like, past tense, you know, dugged. It's not easy being here. I'm telling you. It's tough. You should see what she's doing. She's taking a scarf and hanging herself from the bathroom door. This is really beat. Why can't I just do my show? Why? William is having a good time. He's behind the camera. Ah! He's having a great old time. The producer's having a nervous breakdown. Someone give her mouth to mouth. She's passing out. Come on, that's my wife. She's dying. Everybody, give her, pump that breast. Come on. No, not that breast. The chest. She's out of breath. Ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, espero que la hayan pasado bien aquí en vivo en escena conmigo, Lucio Fernandez, su anfitrión. Véannos toda la semana. Nos pueden ver en el internet por todos lados. Estamos en el mundo entero. Ladies and gentlemen, check us out every single week right here on live on stage. Please, what do you want? Okay, enough. You know, David Letterman never gets his treatment. You know, yes, he's got a good producer, but he never has makeup on stage. You notice that? I have makeup on stage. This is big time, people. This is big time. This is getting so high tech. I have monitors there, monitors here, monitors here. I'm looking at everything. This is incredible. Anyway, check me out online. What's my website? www.luciofernandez.com. Check out the show. This is incredible. Till next time, I am your host, Lucio Fernandez. Good night, everybody. Peace out, baby. Come closer, William. Feel, I want to feel the love, William. Come on, don't be like Jay. Come closer. Come into my eye. Peace out, everybody.